And we've got Glenn and Beeb from the Little River Band in the studio with us, having a bit of a chuckle. Does that bring back some funny memories for you or something, does it?
Yeah, I haven't seen that film.
That was at a ball at Camberwell.
Is that where you did that?
Yes, very important gig.
I remember that. Yeah. Very important.
How did you feel way back then when that record came out? Did you think that the Little River Band would get to where it is today, or were you hoping for, or what? What were your feelings at the time?
I think every band has hopes and dreams of making it on an international level. That's, you know, I think Australian bands do, just like any other bands in the world.
Yeah. Well, since that record came out, you've had numerous hit singles, three hit albums. You've gone to the United States. You've done numerous tours around Australia. You must be feeling pretty good at the moment. You're just about to embark on another tour.
We're feeling good but tired at the same time.
Yeah, I'm so popular now, Lee. I'm so popular now that for the first time in 15 years, my father came to see me perform.
Yeah.
Well, there you have it. Yeah. What did he think?
Hated it.
He sat through the concert like this.
Yeah, right.
Oh, really? Uh-huh. Never mind. Beeb, both of those little segments featured Roger McLaughlin and also Rick Formosa, who, of course, aren't in the band any longer. That was probably the first big change in the Little River Band. Do you want to talk a little bit about that time and what brought those changes about and why you got the new members?
Well, basically, it was that Rick was sort of diverting to his own type of music, which is kind of a jazz rock type thing that he would really like to do now. In fact, I think it won't be long before Rick does an album, and Roger is at the moment now with Stars, playing with Stars.
That's right.
Which is really good for him, because for a long time Roger didn't do anything, and you know, we were kind of wondering whether he was going to stay with it or not.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was a strange period for us during that time, and
everything seems to have worked out admirably, though.
It seems, you know, like we're still good friends, all of us, and Ricky Formosa still works with us quite a lot, you know, arranging the strings and conducting the strings on stage and conducting the brass sections that we have playing with us.
Well, tomorrow night's the big night, your last concert in Melbourne at the Palais. Yeah. Everything ready for that?
Yeah, tomorrow night we break up.
You got one more after that too, right? Geelong on Sunday at the Plaza
Theatre.
That's
right, yeah.
Can you just quickly tell us about tomorrow night? As well as the band, you've got some strings and a few other tricky
things. Yeah, mainly in the capital cities, we've been using a 13-piece string section with Rick conducting them, and also a 5-piece brass section, makes the concert a little bit more interesting, you know.
Yeah.
Good, there's a nice
And it's been working really well too, you know. And
there are still some tickets available for tomorrow night. There's not all that many left.
Yeah.
You've just
are
about
there?
Sold out.
I think so.
Yeah, there are very few left, but there are some.
Yeah.
So if you get a chance, catch the Little River Band tomorrow at the Palais Theatre.
The theatre's looking great too.
Yeah. Tremendous. I had a look at it today. It was very good.
Good one.
It's a good concert hall, I think.
Yeah, unusual place to have a concert. You've got 1 week holiday after that, then you're off to the US once again. It was almost 12 months ago to the day that you went there for the first time. You're just about to embark on your second tour. How did you feel at the time when you know, as you were about to leave?
Well, we sort of went across not knowing what to expect, and a lot of the gigs over there were sort of like one night we'd do a 7,000-seater with average wide band, and the next night we'd be in Washington playing a little club like the Child Herald, which held maybe 200 people, and it was up and down like that all over the country, you know. But when our booking agent saw us in LA, he decided then that we'd do mainly concerts this time, you know, which is going to be good for us because we prefer to do concerts.
Thanks very much for coming in on behalf of Nightmoves and everybody in Melbourne, actually.
Yeah.
Best of luck for the overseas tour. You really deserve the best. So I hope everything turns out exactly as you'd like.
Best of luck for your show too, man.
Hey, thanks very much.
Yeah.